Now, what are your chances of survival in a plane crash?
Ooh. I'm guessing it's going to be one of these where there are loads and loads and loads of plane crashes, but usually no one dies.
Yeah, it's more or less true.
So statistically...
I imagine it swings on the whistle that you get on the life jacket. I think that's probably what saves the lives of people. And if it's that kind of plane crash that's never happened, where the plane lightly bobs onto the water, everyone gets out nicely, takes their high heels off, inflates the thing, tops it up, and then, oh, help doesn't seem to have come. I know. Oh, that's all right. Here come the American
army. It does
army
rather rely on someone having quite selective hearing.
I'm going, I didn't hear that plane go down, but...
Imagine anything more... I can't imagine anything more pathetic.
What if there's a
load of air travellers bobbing along in the water going, ping, ping, ping!
What they should give is everyone gets a different note. You get a little songbook.
Yeah. Well, wouldn't it be tragic though if you were playing a little song and one of the notes didn't go off and you went, didn't make it.
Oh dear. I see Dave's been eaten by sharks. Yeah. We're going to have to play chopsticks. Yeah.
Let's do South Pacific. We can do the show right here.
I heard a great, an urban legend about the brace position. Someone told me that the reason they want you to put your head between your legs is so to preserve the dental record.
I don't think it's true.
I heard that as well. And actually, I don't know why they don't just tell people that. You know, in the unlikely event of your death, I'm sure you'll all agree you'd like to be identified.
Leave.
Bite down hard on your own armrest.
Oh dear. Well, in fact, between 83 and 2000, in the US, there were 568 plane crashes. 53,487 people aboard, 51,207 survived. The main problem experienced is, oddly enough, getting seatbelts off. Although, you know, we all get bored by the hostess reminding us how this incredibly simple buckle works, but apparently under stress, people revert to trying to undo them the way that's familiar to them in a car. So, yeah, the fact is, it is very unlikely. The reason you're made to open the window blinds when you're landing, and that they turn off the cabin lights and make it dark on landing, is if there's an accident, the emergency services can see in through the windows if they need to, and also so that passengers' eyes are accustomed to low light in case they need to evacuate in the dark.